disease.
What sound to you? Noise. What sound to you?
Iron brain.
Calming.
What sound?
Vibration.
Vibrations.
I agree with Adam. The noise.
What's noise?
I thought the
stuff your ears pick up.
What's noise?
Noise is when you're doing something out of nowhere, noise, music starts happening, and then you wonder what the noise is.
Is there a difference between sound and noise?
I don't think so.
No. Are the birds making noise or are they making sound?
Both.
Sound is noise. They both create vibrations.
Hello, old blank. Are you ready to explore? This might hurt just a bit.
You are reading these words on a machine created by man. As you read, you hear a voice speaking to you the words that you perceive. They make sense to you because you understand. Stand under the spelling. The words are what binds the spell to your illusion. When you hear the truth, like a memory, you recognize it, and this recognition releases you from all illusion. Many languages are brilliant in their attempt to confuse you. Con meaning against, fuse meaning together. Words in their spell-binding illusions have the power to keep man separate from God. You were born in an all-knowing state of mind. First words spoken to you begin the spell. The words come from one of two sources, the tree of knowledge or the tree of life. In ignorance or simply lack of respect for God, many use words that confuse the minds of humans and turn them into projections of their own illusions. Because of this fact, many people grow up and blindly assume their pre-selected role under a dictatorship without even being aware of it. When asked what they are doing here on Earth, most will answer with statements that do not reflect their natural God-given desires. This creates a pyramid-like structure with the dictator on top and each level under it knowing less and less. Upon reaching the bottom level, which is where the majority is, you will find chaos, disorder, and illusion. With ill as its prefix, illusion is a state of insanity. In the name of democracy, supreme power is vested unto the people in this insane state instead of God. Human is now a reflection of their choice. The worst thing you can do is give up your God-given right to choose. For in it, you can choose not to choose. Therein is the final judgment. The illusion ceases. You awaken from your dream. Now the healing begins.
was told this story late one night. The night I went deeper into the mind of folk flight. This story never made the late night news. Buckle up, girls, here comes a tale of little baby Jane Blue. Little baby Jane gets raped by her uncle. Told her not to tell her, he'd kill her with his bare knuckles and chuckles while swinging on some old D. He whispers in her ear, this is all you were meant to be. Her mama refuses to see the bruises on baby Jane's face and the cigarette burns on her thighs and knees. Sweet Jesus, come from the sky and throw this child a bone. Instead, mama goes out tricking and leaves baby Jane home all alone with Uncle Pedophile. Behind that smile resides absolute fear, 'cause this shit been going on for the last 5 years. Her tear glands have completely dried up. For breakfast, lunch, and dinner, baby Jane gets fucked. Instead of a pacifier, it's her loving uncle she's got to suck. He said, let's play prison while every hole he tries to stuff and bust a nut. Once again, baby Jane's got to knuckle up. Who gon' stop the rain? Who gon' come show some real love for little baby Jane? Oh, do ya, do ya, do ya. Do ya, do ya, do ya love your baby Jane? How she get caught up in this sex game? Who wants to take her away from this pain? Oh, do ya, do ya, do ya. Do ya, do ya, do ya love your baby Jane? Tell me, mama, do ya, do ya? Do ya love your baby Jane? 'Cause it's the crying shame. Her mama won't accept the blame. She said her brother loves her little baby Candy Cane. That's why baby Jane ain't got a friend to her name. She's so scared, she's so scared, she's afraid to scream. Is this to be her claim to fame? Uncle Pedophile is deep inside her head. He's so deep inside her brains. They say when it rains, it pours. Poor little baby about to get some more. 'Cause friends and the family been invited in to make baby Jane their little hoe. What good? And will it ever walk through a bedroom door? He ain't gonna be her mama, and that's for sure. Oh, do ya, do ya, do ya. Do ya, do ya, do ya love your baby Jane? Tell me, mama, do ya, do ya. Do ya, do ya, do ya love your baby Jane? Why won't you ease her away from this pain? Gonna put a bullet in her brain, 'cause your brother ain't gonna change. 'Cause to you, he used to do the same. This is such a sad, 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 sad song to sing. Yeah. Do ya, do ya, do ya. Do ya, do ya, do ya, do ya love your baby Jane? Tell me, mama, do ya, do ya. Do ya, do ya, do ya love your baby Jane? Around the world, in a different language, this shit is all the same. Great God, take them away from this pain. Oh, do ya, do ya, do ya. Do ya, do ya, do ya love your baby Jane? Tell me, mama, do ya, do ya. Do ya, do ya, do ya love your baby Jane? They say DCF was responding to a call. Neighbor said it sound like somebody keep getting slammed into the wall. Have you ever seen Jackie Chan's The Big Brawl? Little baby Jane was ready to stand up and woke up tall or died trying. Mom was in the other room flying high on some crack. Uncle Pedophile took a couple of hits and tried another attack. Baby Jane was hiding a hammer behind her back. this child snapped and cracked this motherfucker upside his head. Singing some Curtis Mayfield, she said, Fred is dead. She said, yeah, that's what I said. Everything done turned the color red. With all our might, she strokes his head in a bed, but not the strokes he was hoping for, while screaming out, don't touch me no more. Baby James done gone for broke. Now he's laid on the pool of his own blood while twitching on the floor. Po-po finally breaks through the door and read this little girl her rights. She was supposed to have the rights to life. And mama's in the other room now, armed with a knife, and sliced the veins in her wrists. Red out and died just as baby Jane came in and gave a goodbye kiss to her mama. She said she never had to a childhood never to be missed. Come back to the hook and spit. Do you love your baby Jane? Tell me, mama, do you love your baby Jane? Why wouldn't you ease her away from this pain? Do you love your baby Jane? Tell me, mama, do you love your baby Jane? Why you smoke away your brain? Forced her to spill your pedophile brother's membranes. Baby Jane done gone insane. Now the state got your princess bound and uncrowned in chains. Mama, that's your baby Jane. Oh, do you love your baby Jane? Tell me, mama, do you love your baby Jane? This is when she needs her mama or somebody that knows her real name. Do you love your baby Jane? Such a sick.
Listen.
Silence.
Listen.
Listen. Listen. Shut up. Shut the fuck up. Listen.
We're here at Jaguar Land Rover's semi-anechoic chamber. This is the best place to capture the exhaust note of the Jaguar F-Type SVR. Cymatics is a really interesting way of demonstrating natural frequencies as pieces of art. And what you see on these plates is a direct visualization of these frequencies coming from the car. We can see how the sound waves resonate and move the particles. It's a really good way of making science digestible for people, something that they can see and that people can understand.
The passion and the energy that we put into our cars isn't just limited to the way that they look. It is very much about how it sounds and how it makes you feel. It has a visceral feel to it, and you can actually hear that through the engine or the people being crafting. And we found a way of visualizing that in the way that the plates are coming together with these seeds, creating the most interesting shapes.
The sound that you hear from the Jaguar F-Type SVR is a very complex sound, and it's made up of a number of distinct resonances. What you can see on the plate is each one of those resonances broken down into an individual pattern. It would be like if you took a picture of a landscape and distilled that landscape down into the average of all the colours that make it up to produce a single colour.
Race car edge sound at the high RPMs as well as the performance at the low RPMs. This is one way of sort of demonstrating frequencies and resonance and all the engineering terms that we love to work with, actually in a really beautiful way.
Thank you.
So much love. I want to test your blood. Vibration of sound.
What if I told you a remedy has been found to eradicate all sickness that dwells within the crown chakra, all the way down to the Dantian, where all man's source of power and energy would begin. Now spin for a little while. Time. To listen in.
Focus like a lens, meditate, move the club. It's for my pain, can't make this really good with the love.
How did that make you feel?
What did you
hear? Tonight's talk is consciousness, creativity, and the brain. And if you have a golf ball-sized consciousness, when you read a book, you'll have a golf ball-sized understanding. When you look out, a golf ball size awareness. And when you wake up in the morning, a golf ball size wakefulness. But if you could expand that consciousness, then you read the book, more understanding. You look out, more awareness. And when you wake up, more wakefulness. It's consciousness. And there's an ocean of pure, vibrant consciousness
inside each one of us.
What you're going to see now are what happens to particles of sand and other various particles when a sound resonates across a plate. Because when we think, we're not just sending out a wave which resonates the energy, we're sending out on a frequency outside of the range of human hearing, we're sending out a sound. Everything is sound. And that's how this universe was created. In the beginning was the Word was sound. As we reach another key threshold resonance, this entire pattern will morph into a beautifully and more complex pattern of itself. Again, and again. And look at this pattern right here. Look what you're seeing right here. Look at the beautiful geometry. Here is a perfect cube. There's a perfect tetrahedron, a star tetrahedron. In two dimensions, we've got the octahedron. Very powerful images of sacred geometry held in place simply because we've achieved the vibratory pattern that allows that in this water droplet.
If I don't try, I'll just die. Never knowing who lived inside between these eyes. Besides a soul that's danced here before, traveling through those eight-dimensional doors, explore the Lord. Maybe even hermaphrodite gave me some insight to the yin and yang. She said, all the problems going on the surface of Mother Earth is man's been sprung. Mama's so good, based on his greed. Now mama's gonna bleed to death. Each time she heals herself, another blow is felt from man, cause man can heal, he can steal, he can kill, bring babies into the world. Oh, burnt crosses on them heels, but can he reveal? This cup of love, can you stop spilling yours in Mother Earth's blood? 500 kids were killed in the course of 1 year on them Chi-Town city blocks, caught between this big-ass rock spinning while the other rocks are stealing from communities for mystery Babylon who refuses to stop. I can't say for sure, Your Honor, cause he was a little homie who got caught with the Glock after block after block after block after block after block of sound. Another innocent bystander gets popped. Blood flows into foreign lands where you get them heads chopped off. Why can't we just talk? Thoughts of massacre can't be the way you actually want to deal. If you look into the eyes of a child, you'll know the reason why not to spill. I said, man can heal. Babies into the world, oh, bird crossing on them heels, but can he refill this cup of love? Can you stop spilling yours in Mother Earth's blood? The blood of man still flows through the land. Mama said she can't stand y'all no more, so she don't give a damn. She gon' grandstand the Homo sapiens with floods and earthquakes and volcanic eruptions and eyes of hurricanes and like spinning wheels that kill all in its path. To Libya, Pakistan, Iraq, Iran, African, China, man, Europeans, Americans. Israel, Palestinians, put down your weapons of mass destruction, cause everybody just needs a good strong dose of loving. I said, man can heal, he can steal, he can kill, bring babies into the world. Crosses on them heels, but can he refill this cup of love? Can you stop spilling yours in Mother Earth's blood? I know y'all hear me out there. Man can heal, he can steal, he can kill. Bring babies into the world.
Thank you.
Intriguing discoveries of modern science is the fact that there is nothing in this world that even approaches what might be called truly solid. We speak of solids, liquids, and gases, but these terms describe superficial rather than basic properties of matter. All matter, regardless of its state, is composed of invisible particles called atoms, which in turn are composed of other particles. The air we breathe, though invisible to us, is just as real as wood or metal, because it's made of the same fundamental particles. It is the arrangement of these particles and the forces that bind them together that give to a substance its special properties. If we bring a piece of steel close to a magnet, we say that the steel becomes magnetized. But what is it that actually happens? If we place the steel inside a coil of wire connected to a high-gain amplifier, and then bring the magnet close to the bar of steel, we can hear something that suggests movement inside the steel. Listen. We think of a piece of steel as being solid, and according to our definition, it is a solid. But the popular concept of what makes a solid is certainly a false one. This piece of steel, and any so-called solid substance on this earth, is almost entirely empty space. If we could eliminate the empty space in this piece of steel, all that would remain would be a tiny bit of matter, so small as to be invisible even with a high-power microscope. This concept of almost unlimited empty space within matter is comparatively new, but it is the very cornerstone of our knowledge in this atomic age. Atoms are not solid. Instead, they are tiny solar systems composed of infinitely small particles revolving at tremendous speeds and bound together by enormous forces. And like our solar system, atoms are almost entirely empty space. For the moment, let's forget the forces within the atom. Thinking only of the particles and the empty space around them, science knows no reason why I couldn't take this so-called solid steel bottle and just throw it right on through that wall. Except this, we've tried it and it hasn't worked. If I were to attempt to run through that wall right now, all I'd get for my trouble would be a good-sized lump on the head. But that which would prevent my body passing through the wall would not be a collision of particles, but rather a collision of forces. The same forces that make an atom bob. And if it were not for these forces, my body could go freely back and forth through that wall just as though it were not there. It is within the realm of scientific possibility that there could be two worlds coexistent, occupying the same part of space at the same moment of time, each world just as real as the other, with its mountains, valleys, rivers, trees, and people, and that one world could pass freely through the other world, neither world being conscious of the existence of the other world, if you grant just one thing. Atomic forces within the material substance of these two worlds that are not mutually interacting. What do we mean by this? Let's see.
Here are two pieces of steel. Their appearance is quite similar. But a magnet will reveal a basic internal difference between the two pieces. This one, of course, is picked up. But this one is unaffected.
This piece of steel is non-magnetic, stainless steel. Of course, we all know that other metals, such as brass or aluminum,
are not affected by the magnet. But a ring made of aluminum is something else. It can be suspended in air by the electromagnetic force of what is actually a transformer. The ring being in effect a one-turn shorted secondary. A smaller ring will react even more violently. Here is another ring. This one made of a material we say is non-conductive. And it is completely unaffected. Here is another example.
Several thousand watts of power were involved in that spark. If we replace the spark gap with a copper coil, the same power now flows through the coil. It's invisible, has no effect on many substances, but it can generate a lot of heat. Wood, paper, things that we think of as being quite inflammable, are not affected at all. However, a piece of steel wool bursts into flame instantly. Did you ever fry an egg on a cold stove? It's no trick at all if you have the right equipment. This is a cold hot plate. And because it's cold, you can make it out of wood, if you like. Just be sure that there's a coil of wire inside and that you connect that coil to a high voltage alternating current source. The rest is easy. As long as we're being different, we'll use motor oil instead of Crisco. Fries very quickly, but the stove remains perfectly cold. In fact, if you wish to keep it handy, you can fry your egg on the morning newspaper. With a gadget like this, you can get up in the morning, sit on the stove, read the morning newspaper, and fry the eggs in your lap. Another example of the fact that physical forces can be quite selective in their effect.
Matter originates and exists only by virtue of a force which brings the particle of an atom to vibration and holds this most minute solar system of the atom together. We must assume behind this force the existence of a conscious and intelligent mind. This mind is the matrix of all
everything we have around us. Is the result of a frequency. And what that also means is that if you amplify the frequency, the structure of the matter will change.
makes you a hip-hop scholar. Some subjects you can study objectively. You can look at something, observe it, and then form a hypothesis based on your observations. But cultural knowledge is never objective. You can't look at a culture and say, I know what it is. Or to be more accurate, you can't eat a slice of pizza then say, I'm an expert on Italian culture. Or most people say, well, because I had a plate of spaghetti and meatballs, I can tell you about Italy. This is what is happening with hip-hop. This is what happened with scholarship, period. But this was happening with hip-hop's particular scholarship. People who are not the culture are teaching you the culture. This is the beginning of what needs to stop. What makes you a hip-hop scholar? I am hip-hop. Not, I've read 10 books. I've been to the concert. I rap in the studio. No! You are it itself first. Get the feeling.
There you go.
Get the feeling first. What makes you a hip-hop scholar? I am the culture. That's it. Now that I am the culture, there's no external knowledge for me to go get. I'm the knowledge. I'm it. When I lift my arm, that's what hip-hop does. If I walk over here and stand over here, this is where hip-hop has just stood. If I leave this table, the chair, and come over here, hip-hop just left from here. This is now also hip-hop history. I just created it. This is recording me. Everything's recording right now. The man got a camera going. History is being made right now.
Put yourself in that situation as far as mentally, spiritually, physically, if that's the way you perceive yourself, then that's the way it's going to be. So it's a self-perception. It's like a good eye mind trick where, you know, you're thinking that this is the way of life and you glorify this way of life. That makes it even more detrimental, you know what I mean, to the mindset, because it's glorified in a sense, you know. When we were talking about hip-hop earlier, it was more of a commentary.
Right.
You know what I mean? This is to show you the way it is. This is ill. This is effed up. You know what I mean? It wasn't being glorified in the sense that I think it is now, where, hey, we party, we drink, we smoke, we think, we know this is what we do all day, all day, all day. You know, that's a whole another mindset. You know, so, and you have poverty stricken on that, on top of that, and it becomes more about getting money on top of that. You have violence on top of that.
Boom.
I know how difficult it was to watch us come up with our pants sagging, and I know how difficult it was to watch us come up with our pants sagging, and our shirts all big and bandanas on and repping street things and talking about guns. Every verse was about how I would run in your house and tie your parents up or something like that. And I sold over a million records in a heartbeat. Over a million records in a heartbeat. It was just about lyrics. Mm-hmm. It was about how you was talking about it. It's about how you was talking about it. you were talking about, how you was talking.
What's what?
15.
Yeah,
huh? Oh my God.
It ain't cause you a male, it ain't cause you 15, you supposed to, cause you're young money. You're supposed to, fuck that shit, man. I stuff up. I got raped when I was 11, Twist. I loved it.
I loved it.
I ain't never pressed you. I'ma do you like baby them did me. I'ma do you like baby them did me. I'ma do you like baby them did me. Yeah. Yeah. I'll never forget that day. Yeah, no, they was all in the kitchen. I was scared. It was cool. There was about this many niggas and shit too in that bit. I'll never forget the word. Suck la wine la dick.
Disease.
Burn the living fire! Burn the living fire! purchasing cosmetics advertised to make you lighter. Rumble. Neither do you need to process your hair to make it appear straight. I have good hair, and it's as good as anybody else's hair in the world. And we've got to believe that. Now, in your life's blueprint, be sure that you have that a principle of somebody. Secondly, in your life's blueprint, you must have as a basic principle the determination to achieve excellence in your various fields of endeavor.
Blaze up! Let the temperature raise up!
You're going to be deciding as the days and the years unfold what you will do in life, what your life's work will be. And once you discover what it will be, set out to do it, and to do it well.
Rumble.
And I say to you, my young friends, that doors are opening to each of you. Doors of opportunity are opening to each of you that were not open to your mothers and to your fathers. And the great challenge facing you is to be ready to enter these doors as they open. Ralph Waldo Emerson, the great essayist, said in a lecture back in 1871 that if a man can write a better book or preach a better sermon or make a better mousetrap than his neighbor, even if he builds his house in the woods, the world will make a beaten path to his door. That hasn't always been true, but it will become increasingly true. So I would urge you to study hard, to burn the midnight oil. I would say to you, don't drop out of school, and I understand all of the sociological reasons why we often drop out of school. But I urge you, in spite of your economic plight, in spite of the situation that you are forced to live so often with intolerable conditions, stay in school, and when you discover what you're going to be in life, set out to do it as if God Almighty called you at this particular moment in history to do it. And just don't set out to do a good Negro job, but do a good job that anybody could do. Don't set out to be just a good Negro doctor, a good Negro lawyer, a good Negro school teacher, a good Negro preacher, a good Negro barber or beautician, a good Negro skilled laborer. For if you set out to do that, you have already flunked your matriculation exam for entrance into the University of Integration. Set out to do a good job and do that job so well that the living, the dead of the unborn couldn't do it any better. Falls your lot to be a street sweeper. Sweep streets like Michelangelo painted pictures. Sweep streets like Beethoven composed music. Sweep streets like Leontine Price sings before the Metropolitan Opera. Sweep streets like Shakespeare wrote poetry. Sweep streets so well that all the hosts of heaven and earth will have to pause and say, here lived a great street sweeper who swept his job well.
Fire!
If you can't be a pine on the top of the hill, be a scrub in the valley. But be the best little scrub on the side of the rill. Be a bush if you can't be a tree. If you can't be a highway, just be a trail. If you can't be the sun, be a star. For it isn't by size that you win or you fail. Be the best of whatever you are. We already have some noble examples of black men and black women who demonstrated to us that human nature cannot be cataloged. They in their own lives have walked through long and desolate nights of oppression, and yet they've risen up and plunged against cloud-filled nights of affliction, new and blazing stars of inspiration. So from an old slave cabin of Virginia's hills, Booker T. Washington rose up to be one of America's dread leaders. He lit a torch in Alabama, and darkness fled in that city.
Charlie's fire burned through the night.
Yes, you should know this because it's in your own city. From a poverty-stricken area, Philadelphia, Pennsylvania, Marian Anderson rose up to be the world's greatest contralto, so that a Toscanini could say that a voice like this comes only once in a century, and Sibelius of Finland could say, my roof is too low for such a voice, from the red hills of Gordon County, Georgia. And the arms of a mother who could neither read nor write, Roland Hayes, rose up to be one of the world's great singers and carried his melodious voice into the palaces and mansions of kings and queens. From crippling circumstances, there came a George Washington Carver to carve for himself an imperishable niche in the annals of science. There was a star in the diplomatic sky, and then came Ralph Bunch, the grandson of a slave preacher. Reached up and grabbed it and allowed it to shine in his life with all of its scintillating beauty. There was a star in the athletic sky. Then came Jackie Robinson in his day and Willie Mays in his day with their powerful bats and their calm spirits. Then came Jesse Owens with his fleet and dashing feet. Then came Joe Louis and Muhammad Ali with the educated fists. All of them came to tell us that we can be somebody, and to justify the conviction of the poet, fleecy locks and black complexion cannot forfeit nature's claim. Skin may differ, but affection dwells in black and white the same. If I were so tall as to reach the pole, or to grasp the ocean at a span, I must be measured by my soul. The mind is the standard of the man. Finally, finally, in your last blueprint, must be a commitment to the eternal principles of beauty, love, and justice. Don't allow anybody to pull you so low as to make you hate them. Don't allow anybody to cause you to lose your self-respect to the point that you do not struggle for justice. However young you are, you have a responsibility to seek to make your nation a better nation in which to live. You have a responsibility to seek to make life better for everybody. And so you must be involved in the struggle for freedom and justice. Now in this struggle for freedom and justice, there are many constructive things that we all can do and that we all must do. And we must not give ourselves to those things which will not solve our problems. you've heard the word nonviolent and you've heard the word violent. I happen to believe in nonviolence. We struggle with this method with young people and adults alike all over the South. We have won some significant victories, and we've got to struggle with it all over the North, because the problems are as serious in the North as they are in the South. But I believe as we struggle with these problems, we've got to struggle with them with a method that can be militant, but at the same time does not destroy life or property. And so our slogan must not be burn, baby, burn. It must be build, baby, build. Organize, baby, organize. Yes, our slogan must be learn, baby, learn, so that we can earn, baby, earn. With a powerful commitment, I believe that we can transform dark yesterdays of injustice into bright tomorrows of justice and humanity. Let us keep going toward the goal of selfhood, toward the realization of the dream of brotherhood, and toward the realization of the dream of understanding goodwill. Let nobody stop us. I close by quoting once more the man that the young lady quoted, that magnificent black bard who is now passed on, Langston Hughes. One day he wrote a poem entitled Mother and Son. The mother didn't always have her grammar right, but she uttered words of great symbolic profundity. Well, son, I'll tell you, life for me ain't been no crystal stair. It's had cracks in it, boards torn up places, but no carpet on the floor, bare. But all the time, I's been a-climbing on and reaching landings and turning corners and sometimes going in the dark, but ain't been no light. So boy, don't you stop now. Don't you set out on the steps, cause you finds this kind of hard, but I'm still going, boy. I'm still climbing. And life for me ain't been no crystal stair. Well, life for none of us has been a crystal stair. But we must keep moving. We must keep going. If you can't fly, run. If you can't run, walk. If you can't walk, crawl, but by all means, keep moving.
The river!
Determined, we talk shit, they lotto and buy German beers.
What did you hear?
But the science is a science. See, don't nobody want to follow the sciences.
Right.
See, everybody want to freestyle some shit. You see, you gotta follow the science. See, you got my movement, man. I could take more mixed race people to get more accomplished than I could with 2,000 black people in this small.
2,000 niggas?
Yeah. Right, you know why? Because too many isms and schisms and hang-ups. There too many go. Shortcomings and fallbacks and low backs. Too many I don't knows, can't do's and refuses.
Hey, I damn sure.
Too many fuck that shit, it ain't nothing. That ain't shit, yo little something. You know, too many of that shit. Too much. So they're not worth nothing. That's why the Mexican comes in and he got all the fucking jobs. They cooking the meals. Look, if you tell them to sweep the floor, they don't do like Tyrone and say, man, why you telling me to do that? Tell him to do that. They say, you underlay means you sweep faster.
I don't do that.
You see, it's a science. The black man don't have it. You're an endangered species. You're on the injured humanities list. It's a race of people born in captivity. They have no identification of north, nothing. You can't say black, African. Black is the closest thing you ever gonna use. I agree with the brothers. Black is something that defines us in a cultural perspective.
Sound is the basis of form and shape.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was God. We are told that this is how the world began and how creation took shape. If we put that into the modern idiom and say that into the great voids of space came a sound.
Now we produce two notes with frequencies which are so related as to cause a beat. The note seems to throb, and by using the method we have chosen, this phenomenon of beat or interference can be rendered visible. The figure sways to and fro. The figure pulsates. They are behaving.
Here, a quick glance at a phenomenon with no vibration. Two liquids which spread by surface tension. No vibration is involved, but this phenomenon also progresses periodically, expressing the ubiquitous law of periodicity. Now we excite the surface on which the liquids are running. An entirely different picture is produced. It is even possible to make out a circular formation. Now there is vibration. But then the vibration slowly ceases, and again we see a phenomenon without vibration. The regular pulsation of these spreading masses of fluid. The behavior of iron filings, when subjected simultaneously to a magnetic field and emission, shows that adhesion to the surface is substantially reduced. The magnetic lines of the force round the poles show up with exceptional clarity. If we cluster the magnetic lines together, we can see the effect on the patterns formed. If we thin out the lines of force, the phenomenon spreads out. Because of the reduced adhesion, the particles of iron have certain degrees of freedom. They can move, fall into line, form figures, and almost dance, but only in obedience to the vibration imposed. The particles of iron have certain degrees of freedom. They can move, fall into line, form figures, and almost dance, but only in obedience to the vibration imposed.
It's about how you was talking about it.
I am a young black rich. If that don't let you know that America understand black matter these days, I don't know what it is. Don't come at me with that dumb, man. My life matter, especially to my.
Do you separate yourself from the?
I don't feel connected to a damn thing that ain't got nothing to do with me. If you do, you crazy. You connected to this flag, right? As I'm connected, I'm a gangbanger, man. I'm connected.
Behaving.